Shh! Listen. Can you smell something?
That's the taste of fan conspiracies. Draw the threads together and you begin to find them everywhere. Jack from Titanic was a time traveller sent back to stop Rose committing suicide. Uncle Frank from Home Alone planned everything to rob the house and kill Kevin. And perhaps most shockingly of all the Netflix holiday films take place in the same interconnected universe. Right now, you might be thinking, it's not much of a conspiracy because Netflix told us. Look, they even did a handy diagram. And yes, both these things are true, but if anything, this raises more questions than it answers, all of which we'll attempt to address in this video. Pop on your matching tinfoil hat, jackets, and dungarees. It's time to take an unsettlingly close look at the interconnected world of Netflix holiday films. It all begins in 2017 with two festive favourites. A Christmas Prince tells the story of American magazine journalist Amber Moore, who falls for the dashing Prince Richard while covering a press conference in the made-up European nation of Aldovia. Remember that name? We'll come back to it. Also remember this conspicuous Christmas acorn, which may or may not contain a decree altering the Aldovian line of succession. We got Christmas Inheritance the same year, the tale of ambitious city girl Ellen who has to deliver a letter to her father's business partner in the secluded town of Snow Falls. Nothing suspicious about that, you cry? It's just a simple tale of a material girl inheriting a billion-dollar company by discovering the value of charity. And you're basically right. But wait, what's this? It's 2018's The Holiday Calendar, starring Cat Graham as Abby, a photographer who receives a magical advent calendar.
The kind of Europeans used to make.
Exactly. During her dramatic third act slump, Abby watches some Netflix to cheer herself up, choosing between A Christmas Prince and Christmas Inheritance, establishing that Netflix exists within Netflix, and more specifically, so do the holiday films. Even though Abby is currently in one. And now it starts to get meta. It's Christmas 2018 and you're watching The Princess Switch. Plucky Baker Stacey, played by Vanessa Hudgens, travels to the fictitious European country of Belgravia, where she meets her doppelganger, Margaret Delacourt, Duchess of Montenero, also played by Vanessa Hudgens. During the film, the Duchess sits down to watch some Netflix and again we see Christmas Inheritance and A Christmas Prince. That's fine, you probably think, but remember that in this world, Belgravia is a real place. And Aldovia, apparently, is a place on the telly. Fine. Belgravia real, Aldovia not really real. Onwards to 2019, a vintage year for Netflix holiday movies. In The Night Before Christmas, Vanessa Hudgens plays Brooke, a teacher who falls for time-travelling nobleman Sir Cole of Norwich. First, we see Cole learning the arts of the binge watch as he settles down to watch Kristen Davis and Rob Lowe in Holiday in the Wild, another 2018 Netflix Christmas original. Then, halfway through the film, Brooke's sister Madison shows off an acorn her parents picked up during a trip to Aldovia, our first example of the European country's existence outside of A Christmas Prince. And since this is a world where Netflix Christmas movies exist, what's to stop Brooke watching The Princess Switch and seeing herself? Twice! Hold that thought, it's only going to get more esoteric. It's now 2019 and we've been gifted with a third Christmas Prince movie, The Royal Baby. By now, Amber and Richard are married. That happened in 2018's A Christmas Prince, The Royal Wedding, and they're expecting a child. They're also preparing for the signing of the secret treaty which honours the peace between Aldovia and their greatest ally, Penglia. This is a great excuse for Queen Ming of Penglia to mention how the royals in Belgravia have been marrying outside of their class. A swipe at Prince Edward from The Princess Switch, who ends up marrying Vanessa Hudgens' Stacey. We also get a lingering look at the map, which shows the geographical relationship between Aldovia and Penglia, which just so happens to include the neighbouring country of, hold on to your royal bottoms, Belgravia. Let's think about this. Aldovia and Belgravia both exist in this universe. We know Belgravian royalty are marrying outside of their class, so the Princess Switch is real too. But Margaret from The Princess Switch was still able to watch A Christmas Prince on Netflix. Does that mean it's a documentary? A dramatisation? And we know Brooke from The Night Before Christmas exists in the same world as Aldovia, which means Belgravia exists in her world, making her a third Duchess Margaret doppelganger. At least we can console ourselves with the fact that there are only three Vanessa Hudgens lookalikes in this universe, and that the characters from A Christmas Prince and The Princess Switch will probably never meet. Or can we? The Princess Switch, Switched Again, adds even more Hodgenses in the shape of Margaret's scheming cousin Lady Fiona, bringing up our total to four that we know about. It's entirely possible that there are more. And wait, who's this? It's Princess Amber and Prince Richard from A Christmas Prince in the audience during Princess Margaret's coronation, which means they know each other personally, and Margaret has watched a Netflix show about their blossoming romance, which, in hindsight, seems pretty intrusive. And what if the characters from A Christmas Prince are aware of things happening in our world? Things like, I don't know, the royal wedding between Meghan and Harry. What then? What happened to the countries that used to be where Aldovia and Belgravia are now? Is it all a veiled threat? Would a fourth Christmas Prince entry be a three-hour military epic about Aldovian conquest? We simply don't know. What we do know is that from a large decorative acorn, the branches of a beautiful interconnected oak tree have grown. And if it comes to war, we know where our allegiance lies. Give this video a like if you enjoyed it, and share your favourite Netflix fan theories in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and glory to Aldovia!